I've been asking myself this question. Who is a leader? Is a leader someone elected into power? No, that is not enough. A leader is someone who brings about a positive change. Starting from our homes, our parents are leaders. They lead us to follow the right path in life. Our teachers too are leaders. They lead us to our future. Like our president, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, a man with great humility ever since the Bush times, for he has never shown off his strength and might. Ever since he got into power, he has always been humble, never put his picture on the nation's currency, nor had praises sung for himself, but rather went straight to work by fighting to put fair laws in place and adjustments to accommodate an ordinary Ugandan. With all his efforts, some have preferred to call him a dictator instead of a hero. Yet it is because of him that we can freely vote our leaders and all the democracy in place today. With his persistency and courage, he brought about a positive change in our country. His Excellency, the President of Uganda, the fountain of all honor, we sing a song of praise for your struggles and for lighting a candle of peace for this country, Uganda. Thank you, His Excellency, for the job well done in the fight against COVID-19, although it has been a tough time. You applied all the right measures and you have continued to do so. We trust that you are taking Uganda in the right direction in this fight against COVID-19. People of Uganda, young and old, we must thank God for the work done by our dear President, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, ever since 1986. We have a saying in Rutoro that goes, "Entasime burwagia." Indeed, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni revived Uganda. Remember where we were. We were in hell. Back then, there was no talking, no freedom of speech. If you talk, you get killed. No one could be rich freely because the government would come in to question where the person got the money from. Even the rich would hide because they would be followed to be killed. But now, the business person with a sharp mind will start their business
as to be used in ritual sacrifices, defilement, and many other disgusting things. Beloved President, strengthen the law to protect us, your grandchildren, better. Let people who do such inhuman acts experience the toughest standard of the law. As a quotation in the Bible says, those who take up the sword will die by the sword. Matthew chapter 26, verse 52. And our dear First Lady, a woman of grace and calmness, continue being an example to young girls of how can a woman carry herself. Our dear president has not let us down. He has fought tooth and nail to improve education for all. Through the very many schools in Uganda, like UPE schools, in his efforts to provide education to all. Our dear president has built a country which has allowed private schools to operate and grow, built roads all over the nation for easy transportation, built hospitals to make medical services accessible to all.
Our dear Heavenly Father, this afternoon we recognize your presence amidst us. We want to thank you for the government of Uganda under the leadership of His Excellency the President of the Republic of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. We want to thank you for the three arms of the government, judiciary, the legislature, and the executive present here. We want to thank you for the security organs of this country. We want to thank you, God, for the families in this country. We also thank you for the civil servants who are here. We want to thank you for the politicians who are here. We thank you for the youth in this country. We thank you for the children in this country. God, we thank you for the business community, and we thank you for the elders. We thank you for the cultural institutions of this country. We thank you for the religious faith of this country. God, as we congregate here, and the president of this country is going to address us as Toro region, we pray that may you give him wisdom to keep on guiding this country. As he talks to us and the entire congregation and the people groups that are represented here, give us success and give us fair and free elections in this country. Thank you, Father, for guiding our president from where he has been up to this Fort Potro city and tourism city here. As we continue listening to him and delivering what he has prepared for us, Father, may you inspire him with your blessings and your wisdom from above. Thank you for all people present in this ground. This prayer is offered in the name of Jesus. Amen.
What do you know?